Hello students, now today we will discuss about the chapter 2, whole numbers. I think in previous video you have learnt about your chapter 1. Now we will discuss about your whole numbers. Okay, so first we will clear about what is your whole number. I think your whole number is not new for you because you have learnt about this whole number in your junior class. It means in class 4 and 5. Once again, now just to recall, what is your whole number? So whole number means what? Your definition of whole number. Combination of your zero and your natural numbers. Your combination of your zero, this is 0, 1, 2, 3 up to your infinity. And this is your whole numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to your infinity. This is your whole number. It means 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. These numbers are what? These numbers are your natural numbers. It means your counting numbers. This is your counting numbers, numerals. 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. These are your counting numbers. And here only adding your 0. It means your combination of 0 and your natural number. It means your counting numbers are called your whole numbers. Okay. And your 0. 0 is your smallest. This is your smallest whole number. And which number is your largest whole number? Now guess it. Your natural number. It means your whole number extended into your infinity. It means your no greatest number. It means your no largest number of whole number. Because your every number has its successor. Every number has its successor. So there is no largest whole number. Okay. Now we'll discuss about your predecessor. What is your predecessor? Predecessor means your before number. Before number means if you do subtract 1 from your given number and your result, that is your predecessor. It means you do subtract 1 from your given number and that is your predecessor. It means in simple way you can say that your before number of a given number. Suppose that your predecessor, it means your minus 1 from your given number. For example, suppose that your number is 5. And what is the predecessor of 5? It means now do subtract 1, 4. 4 is your predecessor of 5. It means you do subtract minus 1. It means that is your before number. Predecessor means your before number. It means you subtract your 1. In the same way, your successor means your plus 1. It means adding 1 with a given number, then after we'll get your successor of your given number. It means suppose that your number is 20 and 20 plus 1, this is 21, and the 21 is the successor of your 20. 21 is the successor of your 20. Okay, now we'll represent your whole number on the number line. Represent whole number, whole number on the number line. Okay, now look here. Your every number, it means all numbers, you can represent on the number line. So first of first to clear about what is your number line. Look here, this is your number line. It means number line is a visual representation of a number with a graduated straight line. So this is your number line. It means suppose that your one example, represent 5 on the number line. Here only representing only whole numbers. Okay, so 5 is your whole numbers. Now represent 5 on your number line. So this is 0, the mid of the number line, suppose that 0, and just right side of the 0, this is your positive side and this is your negative side. But here we don't need your negative side because this is your whole number. Whole numbers means this is only 0 and your counting number. Okay, so they are no need to your negative side. So this is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this, you can extend your straight line. Okay, this is 5. It means you can represent this line with any alphabet. Suppose that A, now A equal to your 5. This is the process of representing your whole numbers on the number line. Okay. So now, your question, one question is, can your whole numbers be natural numbers? Look here, your whole number only combined with your 0. So except 0, all numbers are your natural number. It means your counting numbers. Okay. So your all numbers, it means all whole numbers are not natural number. If your statement is just reverse, can all counting numbers are whole number? Yes, because your all counting numbers, it means your 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. These are your counting numbers and these are also your whole numbers. Okay. So except 0, all numbers are your counting number. It means your natural number. Now, we add your whole numbers on your number line. We can add, subtract, multiply, all things on the number line. Now first, discuss about your addition on the number line. Okay, now take an example about that 2 plus 3. Now we add 2 plus 3 on the number line. So for this, first you draw your number line. Now this is your number line. This is your 0. Now you write numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in this way. We need here only up to 5. 2 plus 3. Now look here. All are your positive because your whole numbers, there is no negative numbers, only positive. It means 0 and your natural numbers. So now look here, 2. So we can represent, look here, 1, 2. This is your 2. Okay, now 2 plus 3. Now you move again 3 parts from 2. 1, 2, 3. This is first we jump 0 to 2 and then after 3 parts move towards 1, 2 and 3 and this. Now your result is 5, 2 plus 3 is equal to your 5. This is the process of addition of whole numbers on the number line. Okay, so you can do this way also. Suppose that this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So directly you start from 2, no problem. Okay, this is 2 plus 3. So in this way, 1, 2, 3. And this is your sum. Okay, and this is your better method. Now, the same way, your subtraction. Subtraction on the your number line. The same way, just like your addition. If your question is 5 minus 3. 5 minus 3. Now do this subtraction on the number line. Now for it, first draw your number line. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We need up to 5 only. Now, 0 to 5. This 5. 5 minus 3. Now, you move backward 3 parts from your 5. 1, 2, 3. Okay. 1, 2, and 3. So, result is what? 2. So, 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. And this is the process represented on the number line. It means subtraction on the number line. The same way, you multiplication. Multiplication on the number line. Now, multiplication on the number line. So one example, 3 multiply 2. So for it, first draw your number line. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And now, 3 multiply 2. So for it, first you move 0 to 3. And then after again 3 parts from 3. 1, 2, 3. Look here. And this is your result. It means 3 multiplied 2 is equal to 6. This is your process of multiplication on the number lines. 3 into 2 is equal to 6. So first you move from 0 to 3 and then after 3 to, again 3 parts, 3 to 6. This is 3 into 2 is equal to 6. So this is the process. Multiplication on the number line. Okay. Thanks, students. In the next, we'll discuss about in next video.